Last week at Prusa Day 2025, Prusa introduced a whole range of new products. Smart filament spools, a limited edition wooden Core 1, the Core 1L with double the print volume, PrusaSlicer 3.0 and an XL upgrade that lets you print silicone. I filmed most of the keynote and got to take a closer look at the products afterwards. In this video, I'll share my impressions and first thoughts on the new products. Let's fly to Prague. The keynote took place in the Prague Planetarium, which turned out to be a great choice, as you'll see later in the video. Quick note up front, in this video I'm repeating many of Prusa's statements using the material shown at the event. This is not a detailed long-term test or review. I'll share my opinions and thoughts based on what I saw during the event. Prusa invited me to Prusa Day, but they didn't ask for a video and are not paying for it. I'll add links to all topics and products with more details in the video description. To be honest, these videos rely on affiliate commissions. If you're picking up anything from the Prusa shop, using my code JanTec at checkout directly supports the channel. That's what lets me keep tests independent, buy better gear and do giveaways like the recent Core 1 kit. It genuinely means a lot, thank you. I'll go through the keynote chronologically, but feel free to use the chapters to jump to specific topics. After an impressive opening with animations of Prague's Charles Bridge and a giant Joseph Prusa, it was time for the first product, which isn't really a product at all. OpenPrintTag. It's an open source standard for smart filament spools developed by Prusa. The spools are equipped with an NFC tag that can be written with filament data and read from any site. That enables things like material recognition at the printer, checking if there's enough filament for a job, and keeping an inventory. The idea is not to limit this to Prusament, quite the opposite. Other manufacturers are encouraged to adopt the same open standard. Some filament and printer companies already seem to be on board, and according to Prusa, all Prusament spools will include the tag from now on. Because of this, the spool design has changed, and as a nice side effect, they are now suitable for refills by default. Personally, I like the approach, but right now I don't see a big benefit for my use case. Filament inventory just isn't that important for me. That opinion could change depending on how well the new spools integrate into Prusa's ecosystem. Let me know what you think in the comments. Next, Joseph Prusa himself presented the Prusa Signature Oak, a Core 1 with wood paneling. It's not a technical innovation, but an emotional project. Prusa was influenced by woodworking through his late father, who was a carpenter. This project combines traditional woodworking and additive manufacturing. The wooden printers are limited to 250 units and are being made by a Czech family business. From a functional 3D printing perspective, it's irrelevant, but I have to say, I really like the look. It seems extremely high quality and is, without a doubt, the most beautiful 3D printer I've ever seen. I'd absolutely put it in my apartment. I can't say anything about the price or availability yet. To be honest, I expect it to be expensive if you can buy it at all. And now to the highlight for the consumer market, the Core 1L with a build volume of 300x300x330 cubic millimeters, exactly twice the print volume of the regular Core 1. I'm sure many of you are interested in this, so I'll go into a bit more detail. During the presentation in the planetarium, the audience was put inside the printer to better show the new details and components. The usual PCB bed has been replaced with a solid aluminium plate with screwed-in magnets, likely due to the larger size. You might have seen these in DIY printers like Voron or Retric, but Prusa has added fans under the bed. These help distribute heat more evenly, so the plate heats uniformly and the build chamber warms up as well. A camera is now standard, including a night vision function. The L's frame is mainly aluminium, which actually makes it lighter than the regular Core 1, despite the size increase. Still, the overall width is said to have grown by only 10%. I can confirm the Core 1L hardly looks bigger than the regular Core 1 from the outside. They've also addressed known issues of the smaller Core 1, For example, the printer can now open and close the top ventilation cover automatically using the toolhead. According to my notes, the price is $1,799, including tax for the assembled printer. Please check the website for the exact price in your currency, the link is in the video description. Nothing was said about a kit or upgrade kit, which may be due to the AC heated bed. My opinion, without having tested the printer myself, the Core 1L is a useful addition to the regular Core 1, especially if you need a larger build volume. I like that it's still relatively handy and compact. It feels like they didn't just scale the Core 1, but actually improved important parts of the machine. It could be a very good alternative to the single tool XL. I'll share more once I've had time to test my Core 1L in detail. PrusaSlicer 3.0 was briefly teased. The new version is planned for early 2026 and looks modernized, especially in the user interface. The screenshots looked very promising. You can open multiple projects and tabs, and Printables appears to be integrated directly into the slicer. I've long wanted a plugin manager in PrusaSlicer so users can add and share their own extensions. That would make new innovations like non-planar printing, brick layers or infill injection much easier to distribute and test. I'm planning to bring this request to Prusa directly. If you have ideas or wishes for the next slicer, drop them in the comments and I'll include them in my proposal. Due to the limited time, we move directly onto the next and final product, an extension for the Prusa XL that makes it print silicone. The idea is driven by the fact that around 19% of XL users want two or more toolheads. Prusa's long-term goal is to bring non-FDM tools to the XL. Together with filament to silicone, they've developed an add-on that mounts onto the side of the existing toolhead and seems to print silicone with the usual precision. More broadly, the concept is called liquid filaments, not just silicone. I think that's super interesting and I'm curious to see more materials. To be completely honest though, this announcement raised a few questions for me. First, what can 3D printed silicone really be used for? Of course, there are some cases like seals or heat-resistant molds, but I personally don't know what I'd print with it. I think I'm speaking for many hobby users when I'm saying that I would have loved to see other toolheads in this context, like an automatic release agent application system, pick-and-place automation, measuring tools, and so on. Second, the prototype shown in the lab looked a bit unfinished, which is normal at this stage, but since they didn't share pricing, this makes it hard for me to tell whether this will even matter to the consumer market. During the recent years at Formnext, I've seen several silicone printers, from big industry players and smaller companies. I don't think the XL is unique for silicone printing, except perhaps in the ability to combine different silicones and therefore different shore hardnesses. I'd love to hear from experts in this area what they think about this announcement. That's it. If you're disappointed and were hoping for other products, don't worry, that's not all. According to Joseph Prusa, only about 50% of the new products were shown at this event. The rest will come at Formnext and over the course of the year. The previously announced collaboration with JanTec on the Index system will be exciting for many and it looks like it will launch at Formnext. So, what's my overall take on the event? All of the products presented make sense. For some people, the Core 1L is certainly a great alternative to the single tool XL. That said, I personally would have liked a stronger focus on consumer level innovation. For me, the Index system for the Core 1, new tools for the XL, or even slicer updates would have been more important, especially considering the strong competition from the SnapMaker U1 and the Bamboo Lab Vortec. Still, Prusa Day itself was a great event. I caught up with a lot of friends and the planetarium was super impressive. The presentation could be compared to an Apple keynote, of course, on a different level. I'll also be at Formnext and will cover future Prusa releases for you. If you don't want to miss it, make sure to subscribe to the channel. And don't forget to use the code JanTec at checkout. It really helps the channel. Thanks for watching and see you next time. Here at JanTec Engineering.